वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द ओरिएंटेशन बाई बैक साइड मेथड. इन द बैक साइड मेथड वी हैव द टू पॉइंट्स, पॉइंट ए दैट इज वी हैव मार्क्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ पेग ऑन द ग्राउंड. देन द सेकंड पॉइंट यू कैन सी दैट इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन, यू कैन सी द अरेंजिंग रॉड, दैट इज अवर पॉइंट बी. सो दिस इज अवर लाइन ए बी. So when we are going to perform the orientation by backside method, first of all you place the level plane table at point B, perform the temporary adjustment. First is leveling. Leveling is done with the help of this spirit level. This you can place the spirit level along the sheet and you can see the bubble should be in the center. Then you can place the leveling stop, transfer to the sheet and you can make this bubble in center. This is the method how we can make this plane table in level. After leveling, then is centering. In centering, we can use this plumbing fork. Okay, we have to transfer the point A on the sheet. So with the plumbing fork, you can see like this. Here we have the sliding knot over here. You can use this sliding knot to make this plumb bob up and down and make this centered with the help of this plumbing fork. So when this plumb bob is in the center, we can transfer this point on the drawing sheet. So this method you can see very easily. Now if there is small shifting, now you can see this is the point. This plumbing bob is in the center. Now we can mark this point on the sheet. So this is our point. You prick the pin over here. You have transferred this point A on the drawing sheet. So here this is the position of point A on the sheet. Now with the help of Adidid, you sight the station point B. You can see. So this is our Adidid. So here you can see pivoted around this pin. The Adidid should touch this pin and you sight the station B. So now the point B is in line. So with the help of this pencil you can mark this line. So this is the our line. We can say this is our line AB. You can write down over here, this is point small a and B. So we can measure this line with the help of metallic tape. We can measure this length with the help of measuring tape. So then you select a suitable scale and cut it on the scale. So we measured this line as, this is a known distance. You can, so this distance is 30 meters. So I have selected a scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 2 meters. So this comes to be 15 centimeter. Okay. So this is the point that is at a distance of 15 centimeter. So you can mark here the station point B. Okay. So now we can shift this instrument to station B and from there we will make the orientation by backside method. So now we have shifted to the second point B. After shooting the ray from A to B line, we have shifted to second point B. Here you can place approximately the plane table. Then first of all you put the LED along line BA. Okay, so now I put this LED along line BA. Then you can see the station point A on the ground. From here you can see, and you can turn the plane table till the station point A is bisected. Okay, now the point A is bisected. Now then you small tight the table, and after this now you can see the plumb bob. What is the difference between the point B and the on plane table? So for this you can judge from here. It's come to here. So this is my plumb bob, and this much is, you can see this is approximately 15 centimeters. I have to shift, this is the difference, is 15 centimeters. So now you have to shift your leveling plane table about 15 centimeter to this direction. So this is the way how you can able to know how much shifting is required. So now I will shift this instrument to make the point exactly coincide with it. So you can say like this, I shifted this instrument like this till this plumb bob comes to the point B. Here you can see again there is small difference. So approximately you again write this and you can see the what is the difference. So this is a successive method. The error is going to be reduced in small terms. So you can now see there is about 5-6 centimeter difference there. Again you can check this tape. So again you place the LED along line BA, okay, and bisect the station point A, and then again you can check how much the difference between the point B on the plane table and point B on the grounds. Now you can see over here there is a very small difference of 5-6 millimeters. Now after this you make this plane table again level, centered and orientation. After proper leveling, back sighting and centering, again you can check the difference between the point on the sheet and on the ground. Again you can see there is a small difference is there. Now the drawing board is properly level. It is back sighted on the original station point A, and then we check the differences between the actual point B on the ground and sheet is again difference. So this is the second, by hit and trial method, repetition, you can again make it center. Now how much is difference, you again shift this table like this. With the help of this, you make it slowly, slowly center. So there is one position when you will see it is, the plane table is in level. Now you can see here. Then again you check its leveling and centering. So this subsequently repetitions will make this very close to the original point. Here you can see, stop. So in the continuation you can see now this bubble along the length of the sheet is in center. You can see here this bubble is in center along the sheet. Now this is transferred to the sheet. You again check this. Now this bubble is in center. Now from the back side, pivoted the added along point B, A, you can see this point is exactly on the ground. Now it is in the point, and then you can see this point is coincide with the ground point. You can see over here the plumb bob is exactly in the center. So now we are placed, we are oriented by backside method. This line along BA, the point plotted on the sheet is coincide with the point on the ground. So this is the method of orientation by backside. This is very, very important method. Thank you.